Gathered here today at the invitation of Jason and Jackie to celebrate with them and their desire to be made husband and wife. Marriage is a gift from God. It's the first and oldest ceremony in the world. The first marriage that was ever performed was done so by God, our Creator Himself, when He joined Adam and Eve into holy matrimony. As special as this day is, marriage is a lot more than what we see here, a lot more than what we feel here, and what we celebrate together. Marriage is more than a commitment, more than a contract. Marriage is, in the words of Jesus, a covenant. It is when two very special people become one in the eyes of God and man. And it is into this holy union that Jason and Jackie come today to be joined. Let us bow our heads together for worship. Our most gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity you have provided to us on this special day to enjoy and celebrate with Jason and Jackie their desire, Lord, to begin their lives together today as a husband and a wife. We thank you for what we see here, for what we feel here, and for what we know is happening. We certainly, with all that we say and do this afternoon, want to bring honor and glory to your name. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Jason Kane, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be faithful to her so long as you both shall live. That is Jackie Gatton. Will you have this man be your husband, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be faithful to him so long as you both shall live. Will all of you witnessing these two persons and their commitment today do everything within your power to uphold them in their marriage? If so, please answer, we will.
We will.
Who has given this woman to be married?
Her family.
In the Old Testament, we find a book named after a very special lady. Her name is Ruth. Ruth had a sister whose name was Orpah. For all practical intents and purposes, they were a normal family. Big dreams, big plans, everything was equal and well contained. But as is true for every family and every relationship, they had some trials and they had some tests and they came through some tough times. It was a famine for the nation, it became a funeral for the family. The father-in-law died, unfortunately, both husbands. And early on in the book of Ruth, we find this exchange between Naomi, who was her mother-in-law, and her two daughters-in-law. And they had a choice. One choice was in the face of difficult circumstances and tough choices and big decisions. One choice was to go their own way and do their own thing. The other choice was the choice that I want to leave you with today, is the choice that Ruth made. And it summed up best in her own words in Ruth chapter 1, verse 15. And when Naomi said, "Look, your sister-in-law is going back to her people and back to her gods. Go back to them." But Ruth replied, "Do not urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. And may the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if even death separates you and me." And when Naomi realized that Ruth was determined to go with her, she stopped urging her. So the two women went home, the Bible says, until they came to the town of Bethlehem. Ruth did the honorable thing. She did the right thing. She chose God, and they chose one another. And I want to leave that with you today. When you don't know what to do, choose God, choose one another. When you wonder what decision we're going to make, you choose God, and you choose one another. When it gets tough financially, when it gets tough in a relationship, when life just gets tough, you always choose God, and you choose one another. And the cool thing about that story is in the book of Matthew chapter 1, this lady Ruth, who made the right decision, is named in the genealogy of Jesus Christ. What a really cool story. And today I want to leave you with that, that you choose God, and you choose man. You have come today to be made husband and wife, and we'll ask you to repeat these vows. I, Jason, take you, Jackie, to be my wife.
I, Jason, take you, Jackie, to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forth.
From this day forth.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For rich or for poor.
For richness or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
I, Jackie, take you, Jason, to be my husband. To have and to hold. And to take for. For better or for worse. For rich or for poor. In sickness and in health. And to love and to care. Until we are parted by death. As God is my will. I give you my promise. Can I have a ring, please? First Corinthians chapter 13, the Bible describes true love as patient and kind, and true love that does not envy, it does not boast, and it's never proud. True love, the Bible says, is never rude. It's never in it for itself, it's not easily angered, and it never keeps a record of wrong. True love does not delight in evil, but it rejoices in the truth. And it always protects, it always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. The Bible says that this kind of love never fails. And as you wear these rings from this day forward, may they serve as constant reminders of the covenant of love that y'all are making it for one. Jason, I'm going to put this ring with a ring finger. I give you this ring.
I give you this rope.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I choose you.
I choose you.
I love you.
I love you.
And I honor you.
And I honor you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow, and with all that I am, and all that I have, I choose you, I love you, and I honor you. bow our heads together for a word of prayer. Our most gracious and heavenly Father, again, we come today asking your blessing upon these lives, this home that is established. You have made us so that we are incomplete without the other, so that we yearn for someone whom we can love and whose love we can receive. May Jason and Jackie come to know and experience your best for their life and their marriage. And today, before you and man, they have become one. May their union provide fulfillment physically, emotionally, and spiritually. When joy comes, may they share it together. When sorrow threatens, may they bear it together. And in the good times and the bad, during the highs and the lows, may they ever draw closer to one another, as together they draw nearer. Grant them, we pray today, patience, gentleness, forbearance, and understanding. Protect their home and their love from those forces that would seek to break it apart. We pray this prayer today in the name that is above all names, in the name of our Savior and our friend, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Jason and Jackie, your marriage can withstand every trial, tribulation, and test. Not by the authority of the state, or even by the strength of your certificate, but by the strength of your love and commitment to one another, and by the power of your faith in one another and in God. I'm going to ask you out loud to one another to repeat this statement. We surrender our marriage to the Lord.
We surrender ours to the Lord.
As together we seek.
As together we seek.
To glorify Him.
To glorify Him.
As a husband and wife.
As a husband and wife.
Together we'll serve the Lord.
Together we will serve the Lord.
And build a house of
faith. And build a house of faith.
Therefore, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and in accordance to the laws of God and the sovereign state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jason, you may kiss me. Friends and family, I am honored to introduce to you today Mr. and Mrs. Jason Kane. Thank you for being out here today and for sharing and celebrating with them and their family. And I know you guys are welcome to move over to the big tent and party. God bless you. Thank you.